did you kind of want to take a break for a little bit? Like, what was your mindset afterwards?
Yeah, that's a good question. So I think I probably, it's hard, you know, there's no manual to read for. Once you have extreme success, here's what you do.
Right, yeah. It's different for everyone.
Totally, depending on their own goals and dreams and growth and shifts and industry, you know. And I think it caught me off guard because it wasn't like, okay, guys, this is going to be your last season. Like, we did the season and we didn't know it was going to get canceled. So it was really anticlimactic in terms of closure.
Yeah.
And I think that probably was part of the thing that made me feel so weird afterwards. And I was just, what do I do now? Like, oh, we're not going back. Oh, it's over? Oh.
Yeah.
Now what? So then I accepted some jobs that, I don't know. I do best when I'm clear on what I want to do.
Mm-hmm.
And when I know what I want to do creatively and where my headspace is at, everything goes into alignment. And I think I was a little bit thrown off that it had ended and I didn't know what I wanted to do. So then you don't have a compass.
Right.
So then you just kind of say yes to stuff because you're like, oh, okay.
Mm-hmm.
Which then kind of, I don't know, maybe it wasn't creatively or business navigation, like the greatest choices in the world in terms of that narrative.
Mm-hmm.
But I had to learn from that and I had to go through it. And I think it was in my own space, not feeling totally clear on what I want to do next or where mm-hmm. am I at now? Who am I as an artist right now? What am I craving right. to communicate? And what zone of play do I want to be in? So it took me a bit of time. I had an agent go, just do nothing for a while. And I was like, what? After Dharma Gray, like do nothing? Like that just sounded like just go die or something, you know, because I like being productive. So it was a bit of like a second puberty where I just felt like, and then, you know, with some highs and lows and okay, let's try again.
Mm-hmm.
Till I finally just made some changes and got clear on what I wanted to do. I allowed myself the time and space and also had two kids and, you know, so I had to kind of reset as an artist and go, what truly, taking into consideration no life phenomena, nothing, just me, what is it that I want to, how do I want to express myself?
Mm-hmm.
In what sandbox do I want to play in? To accomplish that. And I was like, you know, I've had so many experiences in my life. I've lobbied in DC for social justice causes. I've raised two kids. I've done other, you know, I've just done a lot. Had a lot of experiences. And I went, I want to express myself as a woman,
mm-hmm.
not a girl. And I want to delve into the human condition. And I want to touch people and make them feel their own heart again and remind people that they're a living, breathing soul that can live.
Right.
And I want to express myself as a woman and not fight against the fact that I'm in my 40s, but fucking embrace it and communicate from it and the beauty and the strength of that. And then 10 days later, I got offered Fear the Walking Dead.